2-1-0, and liftoff, the final liftoff of Atlantis.
Shuttle Atlantis blasted off for the very last time, the end of an era for the U.S. space program.
The space shuttle spreads its wings one final time for the start of a sentimental journey into history.
Atlantis quickly disappeared into the clouds, not exactly the picture-perfect launch spectators hoped for, but a remarkable achievement for NASA, the 135th and final shuttle mission.
Engines now revving up, standing by for the throttle-up call.
The crew of four snapped photos this morning before suiting up and getting on board.
DMS-1, come check.
Usually six or seven astronauts fly, but since this is the last mission, there's no backup shuttle for an emergency rescue. Russia will lend its Soyuz rocket if the astronauts run into trouble.
Up to a million spectators gathered across coastal Florida to watch today's final launch and be a part of U.S. space history.
I just think that it's so sad that this is the last one.
Atlantis will deliver a year's worth of supplies to the International Space Station during its 12-day mission.
Atlantis safely in its preliminary orbit, following a flawless launch from the Kennedy Space Center.
For more than 50 years, the U.S. has been in the forefront of manned space exploration.
Oh, it's beautiful, Mike.
At least for now, that time has come to an end as NASA works on ways to take us even deeper into space. Manuel Gallegos, CBS News, at the Kennedy Space Center.